This is Ritika Dutt, right? Today I'm going to talk on the topic the Mesolithic or the Middle Age. So from the term Mesolithic Age only, we can understand that this talks about Middle Age, a phase that the world has gone through. What are the changes that has taken place? What are the new tools and new excavations that the Mesolithic Age experienced and or witnessed? And what are the new sites, Mesolithic sites, have come up after this age? So today we are going to talk, or we are going to summarize in a very brief manner about all these. So the Pleistocene geological era was made way for the Holocene about 10,000 years ago. Many environmental changes took place during this transition, and there are detailed profiles of climatic patterns. The transition from a hunting-gathering stage to the beginnings of settled agriculture can be traced at Chobani Mando, which is considered as one of the important Mesolithic sites. The Chobani Mando has, in Belan Valley, it has three divisions, out of which the second division is considered to be based on the Mesolithic period. The term Mesolithic is generally used for the post-Pleistocene, that is Holocene, hunting-gathering, Stone Age, cultured marked by the use of microliths. So this is a very important term which we are going to find in this entire video, that is microliths. Because microlith is something which plays a very important role in the Mesolithic period. So there were changes in the stone toolkits of prehistoric people. Mesolithic tools include blade, geometric microliths like triangles, trapezes, crescents. However, there are few examples of portable Mesolithic art. A chart core engraved with an interesting design was found in Chandrahati in Rajasthan. It is assumed to be Mesolithic because lots of microliths have been found at this particular site of Rajasthan, that is called Chandrahati. Few engraved bone objects have been found at the site, such as Bhimbetka. Mesolithic paintings have also been at sites in Madhya Pradesh, such as Kharwar, Chaura, Tathotia, Lakhanjur. So these are few sites where Mesolithic art has become very popular. However, Mesolithic communities fanned out into new ecological niches, and the evidence of rock art provided notable information about their lives and aesthetic sensibilities. Mesolithic people obtained their food through hunting and gathering. The animal bones, which is to dominate the Mesolithic period, were found at some Mesolithic sites, indicate that the beginning of animal domestication can be traced from this phase of Mesolithic age. Like animals, different animals were domesticated. And so we can see many remarkable changes taking place in the Mesolithic period. Like there were changes in tools, there were changes in occupations, agricultural occupations. From hunter-gatherers, they were slowly shifting towards something agricultural. So this is a very significant age we can talk about, and this place, this particular Mesolithic age, like in its own way, it is one of the important phases, I feel, in the ancient history of India. And of course there are many places which are still considered as some important Mesolithic sites, where we will find Mesolithic rock art, Mesolithic tool art, several excavations, as we have talked about Chandrahati in Rajasthan, Chobani Mando in Belan Valley. So these are few remarkable Mesolithic sites. So This particular age later on gave rise to the Neolithic age. So that is kind of a different phase which started with the end of this Mesolithic age. But we can see that, we can consider, as we have summarized the entire thing, we come to know that Mesolithic age has played a significant role in the history of ancient India. Thank you.